This is the specimen of brainstem. There are three parts of the brainstem. The lower part, this is the medulla oblongata. The middle part, this is the pons. And above pons, we can see the midbrain. So this is the midbrain. The three parts of the brainstem will be connected to each half of the cerebellum by way of three cerebellar peduncles. The medulla oblongata is connected to cerebellum by inferior cerebellar peduncle. Pons is connected to cerebellum by middle cerebellar peduncle. And the midbrain will be connected to the cerebellum by superior cerebellar peduncle. Now coming to the external features of the medulla oblongata, this is the anterior or the ventral surface of medulla. And this is the posterior surface of the medulla. Anteriorly, we can see the anterior median fissure in the midline. This is anterior median fissure. In the lower part of anterior median fissure, we can see some fibers, they are decussating on either side and obliterating the anterior median fissure. So this is known as the decussation of the pyramids. So here we can see some fibers crossing to the opposite side. So this is the region of decussation of the pyramid. On each side of anterior median fissure, we can see surface elevation. This elevation is known as pyramid. So this and this is the pyramid. Deep to pyramid, there lies the pyramidal tract, that is the descending corticospinal fibers. Lateral to pyramid, this surface elevation is the olive. So this is the olive. So medially pyramid, laterally olive. Beneath olive, there is a nucleus, which is the inferior olivary nucleus. Between pyramid and olive, this fissure is the anterolateral sulcus. This is the anterolateral sulcus, and lateral to olive is the posterolateral sulcus. Lateral to olive is the posterolateral sulcus. This is anterior median fissure. Then there is pyramid. Then there is anterolateral sulcus. Then there is the olive, and there is a posterolateral sulcus. The anterolateral sulcus is also known as pre-olivary sulcus, and the posterolateral sulcus is also known as post-olivary sulcus. Lateral to this, we can see here a thick bundle which is going up and laterally. This is the inferior cerebellar peduncle. So this is inferior cerebellar peduncle on each side. This inferior cerebellar peduncle will connect the medulla with the respective hemispheres of the cerebellum. So this is the inferior, this is inferior cerebellar peduncle. Now the important cranial nerves which are attached on the ventral surface of the medulla, between pyramid and olive, there is attachment of the rootlets of hypoglossal nerve, which is the 12th cranial nerve. So hypoglossal nerve will be seen emerging from the anterolateral sulcus between pyramid and olive. Lateral to olive, that is post-olivary sulcus, gives attachment to three cranial nerves. From above downwards, they are the glossopharyngeal nerve, that is the 9th cranial nerve. Below which there is attachment of the vagus, that is the 10th cranial nerve, and below which there will be cranial root of accessory nerve. So above downwards, lateral to olive, we can see the emergence of three nerves, 9, 10 and cranial part of 11. This junction between the pons and medulla, this junction is the pontomedullary junction, and there are three cranial nerves which are attached at this junction. From medial to lateral, these are the abducens nerve, lateral to which is the facial nerve, and lateral to which is the vestibulocochlear nerve. So on each side of midline, we can see attachment of three cranial nerves at pontomedullary junction. From medial to lateral, sixth, that is abducens nerve, seventh, that is a facial nerve, and the vestibulocochlear, that is the eighth cranial nerve. We can actually see here the vestibulocochlear nerve emerging, and here the vestibulocochlear nerve is seen emerging between the pons and there will be cerebellum. This angle is known as cerebellopontine angle. So here on each side we can see the vestibulocochlear nerve emerging at the cerebellopontine angle. In the midline, this junction between medulla and the pons, this is known as foramen cecum. So this is the foramen cecum. When we see the posterior surface of the medulla oblongata, the medulla is divided into two parts, the lower closed part and the upper open part. The lower closed part of the medulla, it encloses the central canal, which is a continuation of the central canal of the spinal cord, whereas in the upper open part, the cavity of the central canal opens into the cavity of the fourth ventricle. So what we see here is a diamond shaped or rhomboid shaped floor of the fourth ventricle. The floor of the fourth ventricle is formed by the upper open part of the posterior surface of medulla, and in the upper part it is formed by the posterior surface of the pons. So this is the anterior surface of the pons, this is the posterior surface of the pons. So this is the fourth ventricle. Now in the lower closed part of medulla, we can see in the midline, this is the posterior median sulcus, lateral to which we can see fasciculus gracilis. Then there is a septum, that is postero intermediate septum, lateral to which we can see fasciculus cuneatus. So here in this area on each side posteriorly we can see longitudinal ascending tracts. So medially is the fasciculus gracilis, laterally is the fasciculus cuneatus. In the upper part, both these fasciculi, they relay in their respective nuclei, which produce surface elevation here. This surface elevation medially, this is the gracile tubercle. So this is the gracile tubercle, beneath which lies the nucleus gracilis, and lateral to it, this tubercle, this is the cuneate tubercle, beneath which lies nucleus cuneatus. So on each side we can see there are two tubercles. Medially, this is the gracile tubercle. If we trace gracile tubercle down, this is the fasciculus gracilis, and lateral to which, this is the cuneate tubercle. If we trace down, we can see fasciculus cuneatus. Lateral to cuneate tubercle, there is one more tubercle known as tuberculum sinarium, beneath which lies the spinal nucleus of trigeminal nerve. So from medial to lateral on each side, we can see three surface elevations. In the lower closed part of medulla, this is the gracile tubercle, lateral to which this is the cuneate tubercle, and laterally will be tuberculum sinarium. And here we can see the inferior cerebellar peduncle. So these are the features of the lower closed part of the medulla on the posterior surface. As I said earlier, the upper open part forms the lower part of the floor of the fourth ventricle. And these features I will demonstrate you along with the floor of the fourth ventricle. Thank you.